Hi everyone! In this video, I want to show you a game between Grandmaster Levente Vajda from Romania and Grandmaster Imre Balog from Hungary. The game was played in Arad Chess Festival from 2018, round 9. This game was very important for both players because the winner of this game would win Arad Open. I would like to analyze this game from the point of view of opening, middle game and end game. In the opening, we need to develop our pieces, make castle and connect the rooks by moving the queen. Basically, in the opening, we need to follow the principle of the least active piece, and pawn moves are good only if they help us to develop a piece. Let's see the game. White starts with knight to f3, a developing move, controlling d4 and e5 squares. d5, placing a pawn in the center, allowing the light square bishop and the queen to enter the game. g3, valid pawn move, intending to put the bishop on the long diagonal. Black does the same with g6, bishop to g2, bishop to g7 and c4. This pawn move allows only the queen to develop. Better was to play d5, allowing two pieces to enter the game. White wants to exchange his flank pawn to a center one, and he will have a pawn majority in the center. Black doesn't allow this, and he is pushing his pawn to d4. If black would have taken on c4, white has several choices to recover this pawn. One of them is queen to a4 check, picking up the pawn, and the other one is with knight to a3. Short castle, white king is safe, and the second task of the opening is done. e5, another pawn move that protects d4. Black needs two more moves until he makes castle. d3, blocking d4, and allows his dark square bishop to develop on c1, h6 diagonal. a5, another pawn move for black, breaking opening principle. e3, attacking black center. Knight to e7, finally black is developing a piece, preparing short castle. Black cannot take on e3 because white will recapture with his f pawn and he will have a big center. He takes on d4, white takes in order to free the f4 pawn for his bishop. In the future, the knight from b1 can go to a3, b5 and put more pressure on c7 pawn. Bishop to f4, short castle, black king is saved. Knight to a3, looking to jump to b5 or c2, putting pressure on d4. Knight to a6, defending in advance c7, rook to e1, placing the rook on the open file. Black can prevent the knight to reach b5 by playing c6, but in the game he moved the same piece with knight to c5. Knight to b5, c7 is attacked twice. Knight to e6, defending. If we remember, black done several pawn moves in the opening with d5, d4, e5, he takes on d4, a5, and also he lost two tempis with his knight from a6. He came first to c5 and then to e6 in order to defend c7. There is a rule in chess that says that if your opponent lost two tempi, you can sacrifice a pawn, and if your opponent lost three tempi, you can sacrifice a piece for activity and attack. So, taking in consideration all this, white's next move is pretty obvious. He wants to remove the defender of c7 and win this pawn. So, we had rook takes on e6, bishop takes on e6, knight takes on c7. White is a pawn up, but the most important thing is that he has a pawn majority on the queen side. Rook to a7, moving away from the attack, knight takes on e6, f takes on e6, and black has a backward pawn on e6. Queen to e2, attacking the pawn, white finishes opening, and we enter the middle game. In this stage of the game, the plan is different. White needs to start an attack, and for this, he needs to find some targets, some weaknesses. After he finds opponent weaknesses, we need to see how to attack them using our pieces. Weaknesses are pawns and squares on the 5th and on the 6th rank that cannot be defended by a pawn. In this position, black has weak pawns on e6, d4, a5 and h7. And he has some weak squares on b6, c5, d6, e5, f6, g5 and h6. For c5 and g5 weaknesses, black can push b6 and h6 to defend these weaknesses, but in the same time he will create new weaknesses the one from a6 and c6, and also the pawn from g6 will become weak. The next question is, which weaknesses to attack? The answer is easy, the ones from the center. So d4 and e6 pawn should be white target. Regarding the pieces, the queen is well placed on e2. The rook from a1 can come to e1, putting more pressure on the e-file. The two bishops are well placed, they are cutting the board in half. The only piece that can be improved is the knight from f3, and this can go to g5, attacking one more time e6 pawn. Let's see the game continuation. We have rook to a6, defending the pawn, knight to g5, attacking for a second time a6, e5, rook to e1, bringing the least active piece into the game. If black takes the bishop, white takes the knight, and white rook will attack b7 after the queens are exchanged. Another way for white was to take on e5. Let's see that line. For example, after bishop takes on e5, bishop takes on e5, and queen takes on e5, black can play rook to f5, forking the queen and the knight. And the only move for white is to attack black queen. After black takes the queen, white takes the queen, black rook infiltrates on the second rank, and this is not good for white. In the game, rook to e1 was played, rook to f5. This is not an attacking move because the knight is defended by the bishop. Another way for black was to neutralize white pieces that stand in his territory, and h6 was a better move, attacking the knight. Bishop to d2, h6, knight to f3, knight to c6. A good way for black was to attack white weaknesses, and for the moment, white has one weakness, and that is the pawn from b2. Black can attack it with queen to b6, knight to h4, attacking the rook and the pawn, rook to f6, defending, and white can continue his attack with bishop to e4, pressuring g6, forcing black to play g5. But in the game, we had bishop to d5 check, king to a7, bishop to e4, queen to e8, defending g6 one more time, but on this square the queen is unprotected and white can push f4. Black cannot take on f4 due to bishop takes on g6 check, picking up black queen. Knight to e7, a move back that defends g6, and b7 remains unprotected. Also, the knight cuts the communication between the queen and the pawn. White took the pawn. F takes on e5, rook f to e6, knight to f3, protecting the pawn, bishop takes on e5, queen to f2, attacking d4 for a second time, knight to c6. For the moment, black manages to defend his pawn, and white should try to attack white king with h4, h5, taking advantage that g6 is pinned. White continue with g4, knight to d8, a move back. Black wants to bring his knight closer to his king. The drawback of this move is that d4 is protected once, and white can take this pawn after the knight takes on e5 and the queen takes the pawn. h4 from white, bishop to g7, knight takes on d4. We can notice that white has two passed pawns, and in this position white is winning. Bishop takes on d4, queen takes on d4, knight to f7. The drawback of this move is that the knight is not defending the king very well. We see this g7 square, which is weak, and white can play bishop to c3, threatening mate. Let's go to that line. After bishop to c3, queen to f8, trying to defend, rook to f1, rook a to d6, attacking the queen, rook takes on f7 check. Queen takes on f7, queen to h8 mate. So in the game, instead of bishop to c3, we had h5. Knight to e5, defending g6 and threatening in some lines knight to f3. King to g2, good preventing move, taking into control f3. Rook a to d6, and in this position white took on g6 with the pawn. Another way was to take with the bishop. If white takes with the bishop, we would have knight takes on g6, queen takes on d6, using the pin. And if black tries to take on e1, we would have queen takes on g6, checking to h8, bishop to c3, check, rook to e5, queen takes on e8, king to g7, bishop takes on e5, check, king to a7, queen to h8, mate. In the game, white took with the pawn, and we had knight takes on g6, queen to e3, moving away from the rook attack, queen to f8, defending h6, and white attacks this pawn one more time with rook to h1, queen to g7, rook takes on h6, check, and we can see that white is 3 pawns up in this position. King to g8, bishop to d5, pinning the rook, queen to f6, black queen can be attacked again with g5. White decided to exchange queens with queen to g5 and enter into an endgame due to his extra material. Rook takes on d5, black gives away the exchange but it's too late. Queen takes on f6. Another way for white was to take the rook. Rook takes on f6, c takes on d5, and we have an endgame position. Here we have two plans. One, to push our best pawns, and two, attack pawn weak pawns, which are backward advanced, isolated, and double pawns. In this position, white can implement both plans. One, to push his g pawns and d pawns, and attack black b7 and a5 pawns. Also, in the endgame, the king becomes a valuable piece that needs to be brought in the center to help his pawns to go forward and attack opponent's pawns. Black continue with rook to d6. Attacking d5, g5, better was to bring the king closer to the center. King to f7, rook to a7, check, king to g8, rook takes on b7, picking up another pawn, rook takes on d5, king to f2, rook takes on d3, bishop takes on a5, and we can see that white has 3 pawns. Bishop to a5, rook to d5, forking the bishop and the pawn, bishop to c3, threatening rook to g7, winning the knight, rook takes on g5, a4, white best pawns are going forward and black cannot stop them. Knight to f4, a5, rook to g6, stopping a6, king to a3, finally the king comes to help his pawns, knight to g2 check, king to e4. When the king fights against the knight, it's better to keep one square on the diagonal and two squares on a file or a rank. The king should be here or here. And in this way, the knight struggles against the king. King to f8, rook to b6. White wants to exchange rooks and his pawns will queen. Rook to g4, check. King to f3, attacking both pieces. Rook to g5, a6. And after this move, black resigned. He cannot stop the a pawn. A possible continuation would be knight to h4, check. King to f4. Rook to f5, check, king to g4, rook to f1, a7, rook to a1, rook to b8, check, king to f7, a8, queen, rook takes on a8, rook takes on a8, and we can stop here. White is a rook and a pawn up. So winning this game, Levente Vajda won a Rad Chess Festival. Congratulations to him. Here you can see 8 of the top 10 players from left to right. GM Balog Imre, who was on the second place, GM Mastro Vasilis Dimitris on the third place, I am Kostaki Mihnia being on fourth place, GM Tarlev Konstantin seventh place, GM Vajda Levente first place, GM Georgescu Tiberi Marian eighth place, I am Paratoshi Daniel ninth place, and GM Gianu Vlad Cristian sixth place. I hope you found this video useful. Please watch other games from my channel and leave some comments and suggestions in the comments section. See you next time. Bye.